नमस्ते गुरुकुलियंस, आई होप यू विल बी फिट एंड फाइन एट योर होम विद योर पेरेंट्स एंड आई होप दैट यू विल बी सेफ फ्रॉम द डेडली कोरोना वायरस। ओके, सो बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर चैप्टर, आई होप दैट यू विल बी विद योर नोटबुक्स इन विच यू हैव टू नोट डाउन all the important points of this chapter. You know that we are studying the second chapter of 8th class, which is from our history book, our past, part 3. The name of this chapter is From Lake to Territory. Till this chapter we have discussed how the company become the sole master of this vast country, which is India. Okay, so in previous classes we discussed about how they become the main company, main trading company of this country, and second part we have discussed how they get the permission from the Queen Elizabeth first, and how they by defeating their rival they become the sole trading company. Next, how did they get the Bengal state as their main trade port, and fourth part we discussed about this how trade lead to battle, and the last one we discussed about how did the Battle of Plassey won by the company. So today class we will discuss further point which will be going on this board. I am going to write this on this board. First is the fifth point is company officials. Becomes nabobs . It is our fifth point which will come after the Battle of Plassey. How the company officials become nabobs? What is the meaning of nabobs? Nabobs means it is the anglicized version of Hindi word nawab. What is the meaning of nabobs? An anglicized version of Hindi word nawab. You know who ruled over a local state like Bengal. These are the Nawab, and it is called Nawabs. Why it is called Nawabs? It's a history behind this word. You know that after the Battle of Plassey, the living style of the company officials has been changed. They are living a luxurious life. You know that after defeating Siraj-ud-Daula and after make a puppet ruler Mir Jafar the Nawab of Bengal, they get certain things from the Bengal state. Okay, so where they get lot of money, lot of gifts as a gift from the Nawab of Bengal. And after this, their fortune was increased day by day. You know that Robert Clive, when he came in 1743, in what session, what date, in which year he came? In 1743, at the age of 18. His age was 18. He was 18 years old when he came in India. And where he come? In Madras. That is called today Chennai. Okay, so in 1743, at the age of 18 years old, when he came in India, so in Madras he came and he was appointed after the Battle of Plassey, his fortune was increased. After the Battle of Plassey, his fortune increased. Whose fortune increased? Robert Clive. That is become 104 4102. It means 4,1102 pounds. It means pounds. So it means he acquired so much money from the states of Bengal, and his fortune in India was increased 4,1102 pounds. So it means he get so much money from the state of Bengal. And in 1764 he was appointed as the governor of Bengal, and also asked to make inquiry into the corruption, into the company corruption. And it is interestingly to tell you that he was also accused in corruption in 1772, and in 1774 he commits suicide. In 1774 he committed suicide. Who committed suicide? Robert Clive, who was the chief commander in the Battle of Plassey from the company side. Okay, so after this, many governor general come in India, and all were known dishonest or corrupted like Robert Clive, but they only earned enough money and went back their country to enough money and lead a luxurious life. After this, how much money they need, how much money they acquired, they got from this state, they taken this money to their country and lead a very luxurious life. So that is why they are given the title of Madras, because they earned so much money from this country and taken this money to his native country and become the Nabobs of this state. So this is the whole scenario of this fund. How did they come? They earned so much money from this country, mainly Robert Clive. And apart from Robert Clive, so many Britishers, so many company rulers also taken away so much money from this country and become the Nabobs of England. Okay, so this is our fifth point. Now we are going on our sixth point. The sixth point of this chapter is company rule expand. Company rule expands. In this part, we will discuss how the company rule expands. You know that after the Battle of Plassey, they earn so much money and they become the sole trading company and sole person of this company. And how the company rule expands? You know that their main motive is not control any territory of India by launching a direct army. They adopted certain methods to make control या टू कीप कंट्रोल ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर पार्ट लाइक दे अडॉप्टेड सर्टेन मेथड्स लाइक व्हाट दे डिड दे अडॉप्टेड सर्टेन मेथड्स instead of attacking direct to that part they used certain methods why they used economic variety of political economy and diplomatic methods for the annexation of that state. It means they didn't launch directly army attack on this particular territory, particular part. They use variety of political, economic, diplomatic methods for annexation of that part. Second part, what they did? They appoint residents in that part. They appoint their residents. Company residence in this part. It means which part is annexed by this by the company rulers. They appoint company residents at this particular point. What are these? Who are these? These are commercial. Who are these? These are commercial or political agents. These are commercial or political agents. Who are the company agents? Commercial or political agents of company and whose main aim to strengthen the power of the company in that particular scope, in that particular state or territory. What they did? They start interfering their personal personal matters of that state. Next, what they did? They start interfering in their personal matter. Next, they also tried to appoint the successors of that state. It means they also interfere who will be the next successor of that particular state or particular territory. And the third, what they did? They interfering in the personal affair of that particular state and also interfere their personal matter like who will be the next successor of that particular state and what will be the and who will be the next administrator at in administration. So they do certain things and They are interfering their personal matter, they are also interfering their successors' appointment and also in their administration. So these company residents are doing these kind of things and also applied subsidiary alliances. Subsidiary alliances, third parties, subsidiary alliances. Subsidiary alliances was started by Lord Wellesley. Lord Wellesley in 1798. It means subsidiary alliances were also applied by these company residents in that state. What is the meaning of these alliances? It means it is started by Lord Wellesley, who ruled over, who was the governor from 1798 to 1805. Okay, so he was the governor general of in India 1798 to 1805, and he started subsidiary alliance. It means, what is the meaning of this subsidiary alliance? These things also applied on certain states, and according to this, the ruler of the local ruler of that province have no right to keep their personal armed force. He had to keep company subsidiary force as their protection, and the whole expenses and the whole charges of keeping this company forces have to be borne by the local ruler of that particular state. It means the whole charges were taken from this person. And there is a condition for this subsidiary alliance. If he failed to pay the amount of that subsidiary charges, so some part of his territory has been taken away from the company as a penalty. If he, suppose he is not able to pay that amount on particular time or fixed time, so it means some part of his territory has been taken away from the taken away by the company rulers from that state. And you know that in 1801, Awadh, half territory was taken away. Half territory was taken away as a penalty by the company rulers from the Nawab of Awadh. And in this process also the Hyderabad also ceded all their some part of the British. So it means, how did they expand their rules? They don't launch direct military attack on any territory. They adopted certain methods to annex it, that part of the that territory. Next, how did the appoint the residents who were commercial political agents, whose main aim to strengthen the power of company at that particular province. And third point, what are they doing? What they did? They interfere their personal matter, they interfere their successors appointment, they interfere their administration, and also force them to apply the subsidiary alliance and subsidiary forces for their protection, whose total charges were taken from the particular ruler of that state. So these are the things that the company used for their expansion of their rules. Now we will come on the point number 7.
The seventh point is F is the Tipu Sultan. You have all heard about Tipu Sultan. Whom we call the Tiger of Mysore. You know, where is Mysore? Mysore is in Karnataka, a southern Indian state. So, Tipu Sultan is considered the Tiger of Mysore. It means, why did he appointed this? Why did this title to be given to him? Because he fought unarmed with a tiger when he was going to a hunt, and his gun stopped working and his dagger fell down. He unarmedly fought with the tiger unarmed and also make it killed. So that's why the tiger of Mysore title was given to Tipu Sultan. You know, Tipu Sultan was the son of Hyder Ali, who ruled on Mysore 1761 to 1781. So he was the son of Hyder Ali, who ruled 1761 to 1781. On which day? On which part? On Mysore. And after this, who was the father of Tipu Sultan? What was the name of Tipu Sultan's father? Hyder Ali, who ruled 1761 to 1781 on Mysore. After him, Tipu Sultan from 1782 to 1799. Okay, so these two rulers of Mysore, one is father, second is son. Father name is Hyder Ali and son name is Tipu Sultan. So who simultaneously one by one ruled over Mysore? You know, Mysore is the near the Malabar coast, is a main trading place for the company of which items for paper or cardamom. So this is raised in this part, and it is controlled by the Tipu Sultan. Tipu Sultan, who was the ruler of that part. So in 1785, he stopped export from his kingdom sandalwood, paper, cardamom. So in 1785 he stopped the company's export from his port, through his port of sandalwood, paper, cardamom. So these things were done by Tipu Sultan, and after this, and apart from this, he also made his friendship with the French. You know that he likes Frenchmen, and he close intimate friend, he became the intimate friend of French, and also modernized his army with the help of Frenchmen. okay. So next is what we, so all these activities curated the company ruler. By this activity, the company ruler become furious. They are angry and they think that the father and son are arrogant, ambitious, and had to be crushed. It means they had to be killed. So that's why they four was beaten. First four was of Nasrul. First is between the company ruler and Tipu Sultan. First is Hyderabad, second is Tipu Sultan. So these three battles were fought by the company rulers, company officials, and the Tipu Sultan. And in 1799, these three battles they were defeated by the Tipu Sultan and Hyderabad. And in last battle, which was fought in 1799, it is called as Srirangapatnam. Srirangapatnam. What is Srirangapatnam? Srirangapatnam is the capital of Mysore and the capital of Tipu Sultan. At last, 1799, it was fought in Srirangapatnam, which is the capital, which was the capital of Tipu Sultan. And at last, they won the victory, they got the victory, they defeated Tipu Sultan and killed him and controlled over his empire. So, this is the life of Tipu Sultan, who was the sole ruler of Mysore, who got throne, who be the successor in 1781 after the death of his father, and fought three battles with the company, and at last he was killed by the company in 1799 when he was securing his capital. So this is the life of Tipu Sultan. Okay, now we will come on our point number A. What was it? In the point number 8 was with Marathas. You know who are Marathas? Marathas basically belong to Maharashtra. Maratha country. Maratha state. So they in 1671, the third battle of Panipat. The third battle of Panipat was fought between Ahmad Shah Abdali and Marathas. And in this fight, Marathas were defeated by Ahmad Shah Abdali and they were totally shattered. Okay, after this, company also attacked them, company also do did many fights with them in Liger in 1607 and in 1803 to 1805 and 1870 to 1809. In these three battles they were fight, they fought with the company and also defeated by the company. And these three wars also, after the defeating of Marathas, the company totally get his control over the southern parts of India. Okay, so wars with Maratha, three wars also fought with Maratha by the company, and in three wars they were defeated by the company, and the company at last get his control, totally control over the southern part of India. So on point number 9, the doctrine of less. And it is started by Lord Dalhousie in 1848. The doctrine of it was the doctrine of left was started by the 1848 by Lord Dalhousie, who was the Governor General from 1846 to 1856. So it was started by the Lord Dalhousie, the doctrine of labs. What was the doctrine of labs? It is the meaning, labs means to control, to emerge any state without giving any particular reason. Like they have the company given the reason that if any state king